Hello and welcome, my wonderful students. What I'm going to do today is we're going to take a look at subsurface scattering shader, the RS skin and Redshift or Redshift skin. I'm going to go through the maps I created and then also how I set it up. Now this is a hand painted map, so hand painted versus scanned is kind of a different workflow. I'll just be going through the sort of the hand-painted workflow, I guess. Let's get started. Oh, actually, before we get started, just a little bit about this project. This is actually the end goal, is Yondu here. However, I sort of had this theory of I have a rant on why Thanos doesn't fit in the Marvel Universe. And that's because Yondu and Mantis, they're people with makeup on, whereas Thanos is a 3D skin, right? Like, he's a proper skin. So he doesn't fit with the other aliens, the ones with makeup anyway. So anyway, this is my path to Yondu here. The painted skin, I didn't put much effort into it, but enough that I can go through the subsurface shader and how we can get fairly decent results. All right, so I'll stop yapping and I'll start the tutorial. Okay, so with the skin in tech, what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at the three main maps, the three main color maps that I use. And then when we get into gloss and stuff like that, I'll go over those maps as we're doing it, as we get into the spec. Because a spec for skin is actually really important. Skin is about all spec. So you might notice that everything I have is connected into a ramp or a color correct. That's because, you know, you're not going to get it right from the beginning. And you can do a lot of manipulation and save yourself a lot of time just by punching something as your ramp or a color correction note. You know, instead of going back and forth all the time. So also name your stuff. Refractive gloss secondary, white secondary. See, I know what things do because I know what things do. It's easy to find what I want to find. The worst thing about naming your stuff is it takes that extra second, but the best thing about it is you know what's what. All right, so let's look at the maps here. So we have our deep scatter, right? That's your muscle map. Your mid scatter, and your mid scatter, that's the fat and the capillaries and a little bit of muscle in there too. Also bone is in the deep scatter. And then the shallow scatter, that's sort of the top layer of your skin. I can't remember, is it dermis or epidermis? The next one's the epidermis. I always get those confused. So I think the top is the epidermis and the next layer is the subdermal. Actually, and then you have your deep or your muscle layer. So is it subdermal? I don't know. I did a thing on some I did a video on some of the web. Anyway, doesn't matter. I always forget, I always get it confused. Okay, so let's start with my deep map. Let's isolate that. So here's my deep map, basically a color map, and I'll just punch that into a color correct node, and I probably juiced it up a bit, to get that red in the ears. This one is going to tend to warm up your texture, so that's why your shallow tends to be a little desaturated, is because this guy is going to come in, he's going to warm you up a bit. And then we get to my mid layer. Usually I call this my SSS. So this guy, if you're doing like a scan, you can have just kind of one of these. However, it kind of becomes redundant because these capillaries you can already see in the scan. So then it becomes more about just sort of a really blurry color. If you notice, there's this white here, and that's because he has like a silicone there. So I didn't want to, I wanted to make sure that silicon was kind of represented as a, you know, it sort of has that color, that sort of feel to it, eh? And then we come to our base color map. and use my base color. This is not a lot of red, a lot of sort of breakup and stuff like that. I would have liked a little more purple, a little more richness in here, but it's doing what it's supposed to do. It's gonna get blue makeup anyway, so I would spend more time on this and like get a little more like moles and stuff like that on from the actor. And then everyone knows what a normal map is. I do something where I pack my maps instead of having like 4 or 5 maps or something like that. I try to double up wherever I can. Like I'll put something in the AO. When you do stuff like that, never use PNGs. It's destructive format. It's gonna kill you. So this particular map, I have roughness, metal, spec, highlight, or sorry, height. And then I run it out of like the alpha, tells me height and spec level coming out of here, roughness coming out of there. There's no metal, so but that's like my default substance out. All right, so I also have I think it's this one right here. She's your backscatter weight. So what that is that's the thickness map or the scatter map in substance, right? And this is like the thickness, right? So here the ears are very not thick, around the eyes aren't, and you kind of need to clean this up also when you're working on it. The no nose not very thick. So basically what I use this map for is to sort of exaggerate certain areas, and we'll see how I do that later. So actually an additional thing about the thickness map here is I am going to use it in different places. Where are we? I also here use it here for diffuse, and that's to make areas more diffuse and less subsurface amounty. So I tend to reuse that map a lot. That's gonna also like I'll use it for radius or something like that. Kind of depends what mood I am at the time. So there you go. Let's assign a new material to this guy. So actually, I'm gonna just do it up here instead. So I'm gonna hit tab over here, and I am going to type skin, and I'm gonna grab the Redshift skin, and then let's just apply this to the material or to the object. And you know what I can do is I can actually get rid of this. So I'm just gonna deselect. When you do this, make sure you deselect and then turn that isolate off. Otherwise, you're gonna pin what you're interested in, which isn't so bad actually. If you don't want to pin something you're interested in. All right. So first thing I usually do is I'm gonna take my displacement here, and I'm gonna connect that in. Now I'm using a displacement blender here. And the goal of my displacement blender is I do my skin pores and kind of like a lot of my skin detail in substance, right? And skin has those primary, secondary, and tertiary forms, and they actually affect the sort of the altitude or the silhouette, especially when you start getting into these sort of nice sheen areas. So that's basically what I'm doing here is I'm taking my ZBrush sculpt and connecting it as the base, and then I'm just putting my skin pores and sort of like my moles, if I have any moles, that would be in there too, right? And that would be adding to that displacement. I tend to like to do that stuff more in substance rather than ZBrush.